in our project, we have our data set. And I already showed you the transform data capabilities. So let's go into analyzing that data. So let me select this data set to proceed. And again, I'm presented with my data set. I can also select here the metrics and see some more details about every specific feature here. And you can also see that the system is helping me select what kind of analysis I want to run. So if I want to do a regression and do pretty much a prediction, I have to select a numerical feature. If I want to do a classification analysis, I need to select a categorical feature, i.e. they don't have Alzheimer's. And for a survival analysis, I need to select both an event like death or time to metastasis, depending on what kind of data I have. And of course, the time to event, which is of course censored because it has to do with how long we have followed our sample and made our observations. So whether the event has happened or not. So in this case, and given the data set that we have, the easiest thing to do is to run a category, to run a classification to see if our subjects here have or don't have Alzheimer's. So I will select the categorical that I have here and click next. I am given the option to use feature selection or not. If I do, the system will run that, of course. If I don't, the system will run both with feature selection and without feature selection and tell me which models work best. As you can see here, I can also select the kind of computational power I want to assign to this. So I may be looking for a quick and dirty solution, or I may be looking for more extensive analysis. And based on my plan, I have 6 cores that I can use. For the purposes of this, we'll just try preliminary with 1 core, but you can, of course, try much more advanced analyses. Of course, there are more advanced options here. So if you do have the advanced capabilities and you want to make these selections, you're free to go ahead and do that. But if you are not a very experienced user of machine learning, you can just hide them and the system will select that for you. Okay, so I'm gonna run the analysis. And you see that it has already started running and I can follow that. While that happens, and the system will tell me exactly what it's trying to do and how many different folds it's going to try, how many different models and all that. So going back to what I ran today, which is what just finished. So this is the Alzheimer's one that we started out with. Again, you see what is the best performing model. This is, so you see a good AUC. You can also look at what is the best interpretable model. In this case, they're pretty similar. You can, of course, go into the ROC plot and select your different thresholds to see what is your best predictor for what you are working on.